Let's face it, sweating can suck. It's slimy, it's sticky, it can make you feel gross, and it can make you smell. Unfortunately, we need to sweat. Humans, unlike most other animals, evolved the unique ability to sweat all over the body so that we can cool ourselves down in hot environments. If we don't sweat at all, a condition known as anhidrosis, we can overheat and die. Fortunately, complete anhidrosis is pretty rare. What's a lot more common is its opposite. Hyperhidrosis. Now, hyperhidrosis simply means too much sweat. Hyper too much, hydrosis, sweating. So if not sweating at all is bad, is sweating too much bad? Well, sometimes, but usually not. You see, the scientific definition of hyperhidrosis is simply any sweating in excess of what's required for thermoregulation. Under this definition, almost all of us have hyperhidrosis because we don't just sweat to cool down, which is very important. We also have sweaty hands and sweaty feet when we get nervous or excited or scared. And this serves very little useful function. It's mostly an evolutionary leftover from our animal ancestors who would get very slightly sweaty paws so that they could run faster. The medical definition of hyperhidrosis is a lot more useful, but also a lot more vague. Basically, in medicine, hyperhidrosis is any sweating that's so bad that it interferes in daily life. So, is medical hyperhidrosis bad? Again, sometimes, but not usually. You see, with medical hyperhidrosis, it can either be primary hyperhidrosis, which means that you are simply sweating excessively independent of any underlying condition, or secondary hyperhidrosis, which means the sweating is caused by or secondary to some underlying condition. If you go to a dermatologist because you've started sweating too much, they're gonna start by figuring out whether you have secondary hyperhidrosis. Usually, but not always, secondary hyperhidrosis presents as secondary generalized hyperhidrosis. That means sweating all over the body. This could be caused by a heart issue, a gut issue, a kidney issue, or any other number of underlying health conditions. Fortunately, in most cases, the dermatologist will find that you have primary hyperhidrosis, that your sweating isn't being caused by an underlying health issue. In most cases, primary hyperhidrosis presents as primary focal hyperhidrosis. That means it occurs in particular areas of the body. Most often, these are the ones associated with that unnecessary emotional sweating. So hands, feet, face, and armpits. This sweating is not necessary for thermoregulation, and this is where excessive sweating most often manifests. So if you have primary hyperhidrosis, which most of us who sweat too much do, congratulations. It's not bad for you at all. But it can really suck, and it's completely unnecessary sweating. So what can you do to stop it? Well, the first line of defense is just really good antiperspirants. That's what we make here at Carpe, maximum strength antiperspirants for primarily the hands, feet, and underarms, but also other areas of the body. And in the years that we've been doing this, we've become the number one dermatologist recommended antiperspirant brand for sweat all over the body. But while Carpe is the best solution for most of us, it's just the first line of defense. And if your sweating is particularly severe, your dermatologist will have plenty of more intensive options that they can offer you. In rough order, these include iontophoresis, which is basically a system that runs electrical current through your hands or your feet. And scientists aren't sure why, but this does seem to reduce sweating in a lot of people who use it. There's Botox injections, which effectively reduce sweating at the site of injection, usually the hands, feet, or armpits, for about 4 to 6 months. There's anticholinergic pills, which reduce sweating all over the body. And then there are more intensive surgical treatment options, which I'm not gonna get into those here because some of them are a bit controversial. So if you wanna see a video about these surgical options for dealing with excessive sweating, let us know in the comments and we'll see what we can do. Regardless of what works for you, rest assured that there are plenty of uncomfortable sweaters just like you and me out there. And the good news is that many of us have found something that helps manage our sweat very well. So, if excessive sweating is a new phenomenon for you, definitely go see a dermatologist. You want to rule out secondary hyperhidrosis just to be sure. But in most cases, too much sweat is nothing to worry about, except that it can be annoying as heck. Till next time, stay dry.